So editing UI inside an AI IDE can be tricky. It's often hard to describe visual changes precisely using natural language alone, and you end up going back and forth with the AI just to move one button or adjust spacing, and that gets frustrating really fast. So in this video, I'm gonna show you several better ways to make AI editing faster, easier, and way less frustrating with Trae. And let's jump into it. So let's first start with the preview. And this is where you can directly see what's inside your browser and interact with your app in real time. So right now I'm gonna spin up my localhost with npm run dev. And now that you can see that we have our localhost open and we can spin up our browser. So what we have right now is an image editor app I just made. So inside the browser, there are several things that we can do with editing the UI. So first, we can enable the element selection mode. So if we enable the element selection mode, we can select and edit UI elements visually right inside the preview window, like how you did with a browser. So for example, if I want to delete this gallery button, I can just click on it and then tell the builder to delete this button. And then the builder will just do the work for us. So you can see that our builder agent just finished the work and we got the button deleted. All right. And another thing about selection mode is that you can actually edit a lot of your text input and headings right inside the browser. So just like how you're editing a Figma. So for example, if I want to change the heading here, we can actually edit the H2 title directly inside our browser. Now we can see that we changed the text from upload image to upload your image. In the preview tab, you can also quickly test responsiveness across different screen sizes. So if we click on the show device toolbar, and now we can select the size to see our page in mobile, in iPad, and on web. Select and edit mode inside preview is super useful, super intuitive, especially in the cases when it's hard to describe a UI change with natural language to AI. And if we switch to solo mode, you can do the same thing with the select button in the browser tab. So the next part is about debugging. You don't need to jump between tabs or external consoles. Trae has a built-in console log and problem view so that you can see the error the moment it happens. And when something looks off, you can just auto-check directly and asking AI to fix it. And you can do this with both your console log and problems. And inside your context, you can also reference any problems that you've seen. And as you can see, usually the agent will clean up your issues right away, or at least tell you exactly where to look. So it's like having a debugger who actually explains things. And similarly, in solo mode, we can also drop console logs directly to our agents. And you can also select different kinds of log types. And here, I can also select warnings and infos to include in my console logs. So now let's talk about how to tweak designs with Trae agents. So first, you can use the builder agent with web search to pull up layouts, examples, or getting any kind of UI inspirations and libraries. So for example, over here, if I want to make some tweaks to my cursor, so I can just ask builder to change my cursor to a yellow square and reference library for the cursor effects. Let's see how it goes. So you can see that it's actually searching for the cursor functions without me opening up browsers and looking up the documentations. All right, so the builder done its work, and then we can see that our cursor is just got changed. Actually, you can also see that after importing a new library, we got some problems from the agent and can choose to add it to chat and let agent fix its own problems. Another way to tweak design that stick to your brand voice is to create a costume agent that understands your design guidelines. For example, you can ask your costume agent to make this look more minimalist or match my brand colors palette. So let's see a costume UI engineer for Trae in action. So here I have the UI engineer made specifically for tweaking designs that sticks to the brand colors and brand styles for Trae. So you can see that on in the responsibilities on in the agent promptings, I've added our brand consistencies as well as the brand color into my brand specific requirements. I'm specifying that whenever the brand name is mentioned, we should stick to the design guidelines. So now I want to make this image editor to a Trae image editor, update titles and stick to our brand styles. Now the branding update completed, and now let's see it in action. So you can see that in the title, we've added the brand name with our color consistencies of the brand, and then it also updated the footer. So it looks good. So instead of a generic result or asking the agent to stick to our brand in my prompts again and again, with the custom agent that sticks to my brand, it can actually give us something that fits our style. So you can do the exact same thing with custom UI agents in both IDE and solo mode. And I'm also going to share the custom agent template that I just created in this video for you to play around with. So with solo mode, once your UI looks good, you can build and launch directly in solo. It handles the setup, dependency, debugging, and build automatically so that you can share your work, share your prototypes with your team. So you can see that we just deployed our Trae image editor. Okay, so this is how you can make UI editing inside Trae actually fast and enjoyable. We've covered how to use preview and browser tab to edit your UI visually and check the responsiveness, and how to debug your console logs and problems instantly right inside Trae. And in the end, we've also covered the fun part of tweaking your UIs with web search and with the brand aware custom agents. And that's all for this tutorial. Hope you like it.